Thanks for coming to Robbie's conference with me.
Well, I mean, anything for the boy. He lost his father recently to a land shark attack, and I'm here to help.
Well, thank you. Do you think he could stay with you this weekend?
I mean, I guess a good male role model would help a lot. Anything specifically I need to know about him?
He really likes marijuana, and he'll do absolutely anything for it.
Would he murder and perhaps kidnap people for marijuana?
Anything.
All right, I could definitely use that. I mean, I've got that scheduled this weekend on my crime drama show that I watch. I want him to watch it with me. Anything else in particular?
Well, he really enjoys Drake, and I'll probably force you to listen to it.
Drake. He's the one who made the Star Wars trilogy, right?
Exactly.
Oh, that's cool. Do you still drive a Prius?
Yeah.
Did it break down?
Yeah.
Would you like a ride home?
Yeah.
All right.
Say, is everybody still asleep? Imagine me the only one alive. Not a single sound in town. Not a living soul around. It's so lonely on Sunday afternoon. Last night found me filled with joy and laughter. Talking, just a joking until dawn. And it's just a blue light. I keep clinging to last night. I'm so lonely on a Sunday afternoon. Friends, some told, never leave you in the cold. Not friends to me.
Mr. Baker, it's astatine.
There's no way that's the best Metalloid. It is not the best Metalloid.
Of course, that is the best Metalloid.
Definitely astatine.
Baseball signed by Bob Uecker.
Oh, I'm gonna get rich.
Bandits.
Thank you.
knocked out. One down, one to go. Ding dong, gotta get out of here.
He looks like a perfect kidnapping victim. Hey, you, buddy.
Yup.
Hey, what are you doing with my thing? Stop. If you ever cross my path again, I'll kill you.
Yup.
I'm gonna follow you, buddy, and I'm gonna catch you. You don't have the balls to kill me. You can't kill me. You're bluffing about what you said. You were bluffing.
By fiery bosoms, Brother Merlick. You scared the living bejesus out of me. I was just staring at this here cadaver, and you come right out of the woods and touch my shoulder. Now, I understand you took a vow of silence, but there are other ways of greeting a man than embracing his shoulder. Now, it's been a long time since I've worked with you. What we're basically doing here is we're going to transport this body somewhere really nice and secret. You know the drill. You did it at the monastery. So, let's get going, shall we? Dr. Donald Morwick. This is my patient I was telling you so much about. If you brighten up the screen, you'll see that I've been making readings of what's inside of his brain.
It appears to be an image of two tortoises humping.
Oh my. He's a lot sicker than I thought he was. Well, the drugs have been pumping in him now for about several days more than the FDA says they should.
Well, now we have to check it for unnecessary mutations. Oh my god. It's uglier than I thought it was. Are there any other mutations you see, Doc?
It appears that amongst the severe ugliness, he has suffered severe hair loss as well.
Oh, Lord. Well, his body seems preserved well enough to continue with the drugging.
We're making such great progress, but I don't know what to do next. Doctor, hand me Angela. Angela, my perfect. What should I do next?
Take a break, darling.
Okay, I will take a break. Come, Doctor. We must take a break.
Yes.
Yep.
Yep, yep.
You sly salamander. I'm going to whoop your bass.
You got a place to lay your head.
You little rascal.
Be happy.
No.
He may have to litigate. Don't worry. Be happy.
I knew you'd stop. They always stop.
Nope. Nope.
Why don't you come back with me?
Nope, nope.
Where you belong.
Nope, nope.
That's good. That's very good. Mr. Dong Ding, I presume.
Ding dong.
Don't worry. You'll be saying it correctly soon enough.
Now we just need to see about you killing that weirdo and his scientist friend, all right?
No, no.
Wait! What was that noise?
I'll guess.
Oh, well. Hey, come on, Ding Dong. We're going home.
Yep, he's not yours anymore.
Nope.
Pretty sure he is mine.
No, I'm pretty sure he's mine.
Wanna go?
Yeah, I wanna go.
Nope.
Dong Ding, stay back while the men settle this.
Dong Ding! Help me!
Any last words?
Yes. Dong Ding, take the gun.
Hey, put the gun down. He doesn't even know how to use a gun. He's trained in bananas, not firearms.
Oh. Dong Ding, get him!
Well, that's one way to do it. Here, Dong Ding. Let's get him out of here. You're a good boy.
There we go, Dong Ding.
No. No.
Oh. Well, I'm going to go contact Brother Morwick. See about getting this man disposed of.
Well, Brother Morwick, that was a fine job. A lot cleaner since you did it that way. Here, I'll dispose of the firearm for you.
Just to make sure you don't follow my tracks.
They used to tell me, boy, you ain't going nowhere. With your cheap guitar and your big long hair. You gotta realize all your responsibilities. You gotta get out.
What do you mean he's alive? I don't care that he got stabbed in the gut with a railway spike. Which way did he go? That's really helpful. You just pointed a direction out from the basement of my house. You're just a fantastic henchman. Okay, I don't care now.
Julia,
I'll put you over here.
Sometimes, Julia,
you have to use your head on your own. Now, you're doing your little debacle. What do you think we should do next, Brother Morwick? I don't care, actually. Here's what we're going to do. You are going to get your brother, Donald, and you two are going to clean up this joint and get everything that is proof of our operations out of here, including the Cerealarium. Me, I'm going to find us a new location to settle in. Now, I might have to switch between my sister's house on Acetine Street and my new house on Arsenic Street, which I'm going to be going to get today. And we'll go back and forth between them. I'm also going to get some help from my weed-loving nephew, Robbie, so we'll have some extra hands. Until then, I'm going to have to get Ding Dong for a very special mission, so that we can wipe out the weirdo.
Until then, I'm going to need you to go get our Mendeleev friend. He'll be very useful in getting our man.
Oh, Dong Ding! Get in here. No.
It's okay. I don't even know why I put this on you, but Cerealarium has already had its course. You're good to go. I need you to do one thing that I can trust you with on your own.
No.
I promise I'm not making you wear this for me this time.
No.
You need this to stay stealthy. You're gonna go find our friend, your weirdo. And you're going to stalk him for me, and you're going to lure him here. If you can. If not, just tell me where he is. If you find anyone that can help our cause, just please direct them this way.
No.
You don't eat it. You put it on your body. But maybe that's just me. All right?
No.
You good?
Nope.
I really can't tell what you're saying, but I'm sure you're good.
Nope.
Yeah. All right. Good. Nope. You're doing fine, Cereal. You'll get him in no time. You already got his weird friend under your control. You've got the best team of homicidal maniacs in the world. You'll be fine. All you need to do is take this house and make a plan.
All these houses, they look like magnets for Jehovah's Witnesses. I don't have any more room for those in my basement, so I'm gonna be picky. The yard work there sucks. But what is this? This magnificent old tree. I could stick bodies under there and nobody would ever notice. Oh my gosh, and they just got a new walkway. I can fix this. This is fantastic. Enough stoners here to sway any suspicion.
I'll take this one.
It's on delay.
Honey, are you playing the Call of Duty again?
No, I think he's cleaning his acre.
Alright, carry on.
You do not look like the Viagra delivery man.
You may be the old guy, but I'm the one who threw out my back.
Oh,
in God's name are you doing?
Cleaning my anchor. I emptied my load.
And I just emptied mine too. I guess you could say we both got ours. I see you have the strength of many a son, samurai. But you taught me well, master, and I am here to reclaim my prize.
When I first taught you to use the blade, I did not tell you to take little girl cuts.
I know how to get rid of the source of your power.
You will never be a sword master.
You're right. I would never be a sword master. Samawasiku tonight.
Hey, you want to shut up there? I'm watching The Godfather. Oi, Vinny, put the gun down. Come on, I'll get you the money. You just gotta give me time.
Time is not something I have right now.
Come on, I got a wife and kids.
You had a wife and kids.
What'd you do, Vinny?
I did what I had to do for the family.
Vinny, I'll get you the money. Just don't do anything. Nothing to regret.
I don't have any regrets.
Have a map?
You know, like a map. Like it shows you, you know, where you are on like a piece of paper.
What?
A map. Do you speak English?
Yes.
Okay. Do you have a map?
No.
Okay. Do you know where we are?
No.
Then where were you? Where are you coming from?
Mexico.
You're no help.
Just another gringo.
What the heck do you want?
You have a light?
Yeah, I actually do. No problem. Have a good day.
Pablo's light. You Mesocinto and my lighto.
I could really go for a taco.
are you already done then, my boy?
Yeah.
That's excellent. I'm so proud of my lawn, I don't even know where to begin. It's like you took all of the lawn children, chopped them down to size, and made some hair. You deserve every dollar out of the 50 cents I'm giving you for this. But I think you missed something. Some cannabis over there.
Where's the magic plant, man?
Ah, it's not kosher.
Your mother told me you were coming here this weekend. I'd like to know if you could help me get rid of the body. Yeah, that was his. And now it's yours. I should have killed my sister when I was younger. All right, I'll see you inside, Roberto. The postman would be bigger than you. It's funny because he's not a postmaniac. He comes to my house and picks up bodies. I don't know what he does with them, but you don't care, you're dead. All right, well, time to visit my nephew.
See, Robbie, what has it been? 5? 10 years? I've never seen your ugly face in my life. What I can say is I'm glad to have you here, as your uncle and as your friend. But if I'm gonna be there in your life, you need to be here in mine. And if you want to continue smoking my deceased neighbor's cannabis, you might want to pay attention. That's what I thought. As I was saying, I've got a man who needs to be whacked. I'm not talking whacked by harvesting his magic plant whacked. I mean whacked by killing his ass. Now, he's been following me around for a while because I kidnapped his boy toy. So, he's kind of a little angry. So, I need you to help me kill him. What do you say to me? That's what I thought. That's exactly what I thought.
How much pot are we talking about?
More than you can stuff in a Guatemalan tour bus.
I want to help you. I really want to.
I really want you to help me too.
You know, even if the rest of our family was still around after that shark attack, 92, Key West, you'd still be my favorite. Even with Jadavian, Benjamin, Tyravius, and Keno Jackson still around, I still love you more, Robbie.
We only have a limited amount of time, so listen close, Robbie. When that man comes here, looking for the antidote and his boy toy, I need you to punch him in the face. Now maybe I need to repeat those instructions. Very complicated, many steps, but you need to punch him in the face. Preferably hard, multiple times, until he dies. Can you do that, Robbie?
Sure can. Sounds excellent, really excellent.
Now, you see, Robbie, I have a scientist locked in the basement. Don't do anything to him, please. He's tied up. He can't help himself. Now, you see, he's from a pretty good scientific family. He made it, his father, actually, made a giant list. No, wait, that was Schindler. I meant columns and rows. Periodic something. I don't get much into girl stuff. So, we really need to keep him alive so that our other friend comes here to try and get him so he can get the antidote for his friend. I know I use friend a lot, but they really don't have names. It's kind of weird. Not good.
Oh, Robbie. Wow. Oh, I didn't even know you could do that. My sister told me that was physically impossible. You're really good. Well, aside from the back massage and everything, rock at it. I need to know if you're absolutely ready to embark on this endeavor of ours. I mean, it's daring, yes,
and it could last a long time. So long, I might have to revert from paying you in cannabis to poison ivy. more cannabis. I just need to know, are you ready to take a life so that we can take more lives?
Sure am.
Oh, hey.
What are you trying to do here?
Just going home. This is my car.
This is my car.
Here. If we just get out of the car, gently talk about this, and negotiate the deal, what do you say?
Let's not drive you away. Get off my car!
It's my... your car?
It's my car now!
Get off! Did your mom buy it for your birthday?
Hey buddy, listen, I didn't realize this was a gift. I'm so sorry.
Why do you want my car so bad?
I gotta find this guy who took my best friend. And I'm gonna kill him.
Listen man, that's all you had to say.
Oh, right? Okay.
Right? I mean, if you really need the car that bad, go ahead, use it. I mean, I've used it to hit a few people myself.
Are you sure?
Positive.
Oh, this is the nicest
thing. Don't even worry about it. Don't even worry about it.
Thank you so much. You don't even know what this means to me.
Yeah.
Alright. Well, I'll bring it back or something. I don't know.
Alright, I'll just wait right here then.
Alright, thanks, buddy.
See you around.
Alright, you have a good day.
You too.
No.
What?
BTK? More like BT fake. I can't believe I actually collected his bobbleheads as a kid. Hello, precious. How are you, Dong Ding?
Nope.
Slow down for a second, what?
Nope.
Oh, you found a Mexican. All right. Well, I know I just killed my gardener, but I don't need a replacement at this very moment.
No.
How many are in the van? Oh, he's by himself. All right. Well, okay, what do we want with him?
No.
Yeah. I mean, no. Yeah. He wants to kill him too?
Nope.
You don't speak Spanish, but you know that's what he wants to do. All right. That sounds, bueno. You like that? All right, send him over, I suppose. Is he going to try and kill him with gardening equipment, or are we going to have to provide, like, a gun or something? Gun, all right. What an odd Mexican. Send him over, and I'll meet him myself. Are you watching a Clint Eastwood movie? Oh, that's just him. All right, well, I'll see you around.
No.
What a strange man.
I don't know.
You do know?
There are two streets. Arsenic and Acetine.
Which one are they on?
Either which, I don't know.
And Ding Dong's with them?
That weird monkey child?
Yes!
Yes, he's with them.
If I find out you're lying, I'll kill you.
Of course.
Big mistake. What the heck are you? What have I done to you? I'm so sorry.
Well, I don't exactly recall ordering a fruit basket. However, Edible Arrangements decided to send you me here. So, I understand, as a Mexican, fresh here, you have so many opportunities to, get a free cell phone, free food, free healthcare. Your lust for vengeance is so great, you want to join me in killing the weirdo, and I find that remarkably respectful. And I think you, Mr. Gongding, you'll get a treat later for finding him.
Nope.
Yeah. So, what are we waiting for? Let's get inside. I don't have any burritos. I know that's, like, the only thing you people eat. Hey, man, it's... I'm sorry. Yeah, he must have not eaten in a while. I mean, food stamps don't cover everything. Do you eat the stamp? Or do you... You know what? Let's just go inside.
I'd like to introduce you all to my nephew, Robbie. He's here for the weekend, and he's going to help us on our endeavor.
I don't know if I'd be interrupting a mating ritual, but probably continue whatever this is inside, right?
Nope.
Let's do that.
wonder if acorns have parents?
I do. Quite frequently.
Mr. Dongting! Mr. Dongting!
No!
Let them fight.
You're done! Took a while, but great. Execute. I didn't see half of it, but he's out. Great, Robbie. Good job.
What did I miss?
Well, you see what happened? You didn't miss anything. How about we put him with the others? No, wait. The scientist. Put him with the scientist. They'll love to see each other again.
Son of Vladimir Mendeleev! I will not be treated like this!
Alright, good work, boys. Head upstairs, wait for me. This one's always bound. And then go upstairs and have a good time. I guess we'll celebrate. I'll bring drinks and the champagne. This way, gentlemen. I'm going to spend some time with my visitors. Y'all stay safe, kids. Where to start with you? Firstly, the dramatic irony of the situation. It's funny how you both are down here in my basement now. Normally, most people down here are dead. But you two are very lucky, because I am a fan of irony. It's funny because your Dongding is only here because his cerealarium got into his system. Now, what is cerealarium? Cerealarium is a special drug your friend Mr. Mendeleev came up with.
I didn't know he's good.
He didn't know. That's always the best response when you make something terrible. He didn't know. He tried to match his father by making his own new element, but he didn't know that his own new element would make people go crazy. But a controlled crazy. Controlled by only those who gave him the drug. That would be me. I bought a large sum of his product. And I decided, you know, it would be a great day to kidnap someone. And who better to kidnap than somebody who just happened to be walking down the same hallway. I'm really lazy when it comes to this job. So I kidnapped him, took him to my own home, drugged him, and turned him into the maniac. Whooped your butt. So, here we all are. Awkward, isn't it? I might be the only one making it so, but I think it is. To add on to this irony, I'm going to leave you two in here to be murdered by your old friend, Mr. Dongting. And all in the meantime, the cure to the cerealarium, which oddly enough looks like Smarties, it's weird, is going to be within feet of you the whole time he's butchering up your bodies. There we go. Gentlemen, adieu. Oh, Dongting!
It's time for the cutty-cutty and the stabby-stabby.
Nope. Nobody know.
nope.
This isn't you, Ding Dong.
Nope.
Hey, you like Smarties, right? There's Smarties there.
Nope.
Behind you. Just eat the Smarties. You like? Come on, Ding Dong.
Nope.
There's Smarties. Eat the Smarties. They're not antidote or anything.
Nope.
Come on, Ding Dong. They're good. It's Smarties. It tastes, just like Smarties. Come on.
Nope.
See, now theoretically we should be good now.
Ding dong.
Yep. Yep. Yep.
I don't know. Hey, no, cut me free. No, yep. Don't cut him free.
No.
Cut me free.
Yep.
Are you kidding me? I'm not kidding you. Let's go.
Yep. I've been down here for a month.
So?
I missed the 4th of July.
So? You took my treasure. This is what you get. You had it coming, buddy.
I thought we were over this.
I never got over it.
Look, I want to get back at the guy as much as you do. He never even paid me. One more guy, I can help.
What do you think?
Yep.
Alright. Come on, Jesus. We're gonna forget about what happened, start fresh.
Alright.
Let's go kick this guy's butt.
Yep.
Alright. Serial killer's on the deck. You want him?
I'll take him.
Alright. Good luck.
Amigo! Amigo!
Hey, what are you doing? Go get him!
Wait for the pot bed then.
Yep.
Grinning, if this is just the beginning.
My life is gonna be beautiful. Our sun's shining up to spread. It's just like the fella said.
Oh my God.
Tell me
who
quick
does that?
Ain't love a kick in my head.
We've might have gotten off on the wrong.
You know, I had this in my pocket like a shot.
Like this sailor said, quote, ain't that a hole in a boat? My head keeps spinning. I go to sleep and keep grinning. If this is just the beginning, my life is gonna be beautiful. And she's telling me will be wet. She picked out a king size bed. I couldn't feel any better, or I'd be sick. Tell me quick. Boy, ain't another kick. Tell me quick.
Here comes the trench dive, Johnny! Here comes the trench dive!
My name's not Johnny!
Your name's Johnny now.
Had a nice day.
Come on, what are you waiting for? I'll pull you up.
Yeah, that plate is out of the sea, bro.
Good job.
Yeah. Oh.
Good morning, class.
Good morning. Good afternoon.
Bonjour. My name?
Mrs.
Mr. P.
More like P.P.
I'm here to teach you A. P. Treasure.
Why is this a class?
What was that?
Why is this a class?
Why'd you sign up for it?
I didn't.
Then why are you here?
Because my mom put me in this class. Smart one.
Get out.
No.
Get out.
Make me.
Get out! Get out! You guys think this is funny?
No.
No, sir.
Looks like Dora the Explorer just got mad.
Go join your friend.
Woo!
Would anybody else like to be a smart aleck today?
Yeah.
What's the circumference of a pig?
Do you like trash in this class?
It may be an instrument.
You can tie my shoe.
Get out. What?
Get out, get out, get out, get out, get out, get out! Get out of my classroom!
Okay, Jeffrey.
You shoes are... my drugs, Jeffrey.
Shoes untied.
Can I ride you like a pig?
Hey. Get out.
My new boss has a letter for you.
Wait. Who are you?
Guy. Randy M. Guy.
Where are you from?
1984.
Thank you.
We have a new objective.
It's like you have to stop the fight. You're shifting as you're promising. You step through the night. I know you. I know you. There's a thunder deep inside of you. It makes you think it's all a dream and cannot be true. Feel it.
That's enough.